NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time.
Hello and welcome to Focus NC, and this Focus NC a little special concerning the role of cities in a county and what makes them stronger and makes a county stronger and benefits the community. You know, there is some thought out there and not to sound a little bit wrong with this, but that cities that band together create a stronger region. And while they share airports, stadiums, interstates, they have a stronger presence because of the strength each one has in kind of having a situation like Dallas-Fort Worth or Twin Cities up in Minnesota. And the reason I bring this up, and let me kind of frame this for you. In recent days, we've heard about offices and government facilities here downsizing. In Newcastle, especially there was an article about vital statistics and talk about that and some other government offices. So now comes the question, what are we doing to make our core stronger? Are we moving away from a strong center to what could be described as Northwest Newcastle? I saw a lot of articles and a lot of people that wrote on Facebook about current offices moving out of town. Well, at least they didn't leave. They're still in Newcastle. Yes, but they're not in the city limits. Why is that so important? Well, the definition of a city or the thought of a city is where you have a lot of services that can be accessed by a large number of people, and their services are concentrated in a small area. Having coffee the other day, we talked about when people came downtown, paid their bills, were able to go to a couple of the stores, grab some peanuts, some chocolate, some popcorn, and just have a great time in downtown, get something to eat, and then hop on the bus and go home. Now, that is not 1940s thinking. However, we are going to have to refocus on how to make our county strong, but also become helpful to the region. And we're going to take a look at that and compare it to the cities that I was talking about, Minneapolis, St. Paul, Dallas, Fort Worth, and kind of go over how can that help Newcastle. Now, we're going to talk about that right after this break.
Gentlemen, if you want to look your best with high quality clothing, then I recommend Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors in downtown Newcastle. Mike Caggiano is the owner, and he and his staff have been in the business for decades, and they will always give you the right recommendations. They also carry Rondinelli tuxedos. That's Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors, 210 East Washington Street, downtown Newcastle. Call 724-652-3851. Not one, not two, not three, but Four Brothers Urban Bistro. It's where you want to go for your next dining experience. Here are just a few of the many choices on the menu. Char-grilled filet mignon, char-grilled salmon filet, chicken over rice, Icelandic cod, chicken marcella, and ask about the saku tuna, veal, and the surf and turf. Follow them on Twitter and Facebook for daily specials. Hours are Monday through Thursday, 11 to 10, Friday, 11 to 11, and Saturday, 4 to 11. Four Brothers, located 331 East Washington Street, downtown Newcastle. Call 724-656-4980. Daimyo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters. Serving Newcastle, Elwood City, and Youngstown. Daimyo and Olson handles criminal law, bankruptcy, civil matters, workers' compensation, personal injury, medical malpractice, divorce, wills, real estate, and many more legal issues. Call any one of their offices in Newcastle, Elwood City, or Youngstown with these phone numbers. Open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. Daimyo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters.
Welcome back, and let's take a look at this concept of regional cooperation, if you would. How can a bunch of cities make a regional powerhouse? And, you know, this is a very important thought as we think about our own situation here. And the economy is tough in Newcastle. Everybody's willing to admit this. But collaboration is the key to county economic development initiatives. County economic development initiatives capitalize on networks of public, nonprofit, and private partners. Now, this is necessary for a successful local economic development and growth in the area. In order to have that type of growth, you kind of have to have the population. It's easy for a place like Dallas-Fort Worth, who have two big populations, to merge, and as more people move in and you have more jobs, you're going to be further ahead. The research developed by 35 case studies of county economic development initiatives, okay, of which I'm speaking, have shown how this growth is possible. Now, this comes from the National Association of Counties. Okay, and when they took a look at this, what they found out, it's a lot easier for counties with larger populations than counties with smaller populations. Thus, there has to be a thought on what will be the role of Newcastle as just the city, and what will be the role of Lawrence County in attracting businesses and facilities and infrastructure to make it successful. Now, I said one time while meeting with some friends that it's important to care about what's going on here. If you don't have a strong center, things will gravitate to that area that does have a strong center. Currently, I see the idea of vacant buildings and vacant offices in the center as a detriment to our ability to grow. Now, I'm going to talk about how to encourage a strong center and growth right after we take this break.
The Pokeberry Exchange at 41 North Mercer Street has gifts galore that'll make you want to explore. Lamps, homemade lamps of every shape and color that will excite any room in your house. Wind chimes hang from the door to give that sweet sound. Sweet soaps and teas, embroidered towels, and much more. It's the Pokeberry Exchange. It's yours to explore.
Let Clark's Furniture be your go-to destination for all of your furniture needs. Check this out. Seven-piece bedroom by Ashley was $38.69, sold for $27.99. Great pricing on futons made by the Coaster Company. Wind Furniture made in America. Great quality. Sofa sold for $5.47, chair only $3.97. Seven-piece queen bedroom set by Vaughn Bassett. All American made. These are just some of the super deals at Clark's Furniture. Located at 346 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-657-5668. The Cedars is a great restaurant with outstanding Mediterranean food. The Cedars takeout menu is second to none, featuring pizza, stromboli, hoagies, their famous lamb on the rod, and so much more. So when you're hungry and you want that Newcastle taste, make it Cedars, now with two locations in Newcastle, 827 Addis Street on the east side and 1101 Highland Avenue. Call Cedars East, 724-658-9260, or Cedars North, 724-652-7657.
Wow, yes, it's fun to go to the Y, and now with great affordable rates, it's more swimming, more exercise, more family time. The YMCA in downtown Newcastle or the Y Zone on Eleanor Drive in Shannon Township welcomes you to a variety of programs, exercise, and fun events.
Welcome back, and we were talking about a strong core, making a county successful, and county economic development. Now, what are some things that need to contribute to doing that? Well, first and foremost, we can't allow our young people to leave the area at the increasing rate that's happening. You know, I encourage everybody on NCTV 45 when we do Newswatch to shop right here in Newcastle, in Lawrence County, as much as possible. Because by doing that, you will attract more people in. Let's not get caught up in the idea that traveling in and around to the counties that border us or that are just a little bit away is better for us. What you're doing is you're pulling money out of our county, our city, and giving it out. Now, by all means, if we do not have the goods or services here that you need, then you have to look elsewhere. But that's one important step. Second important step. Our young people not only must stay, but must work. Now, I know there's not a lot of great big plants that we had. You know, we had two bigger steel plants. We had two plants that made toilet and bathroom facilities. We don't have that kind of base anymore. However, it is up to those government officials to attempt to attract them in. Now, over the past, year, I've heard about, well, this won't work, and this isn't good, and they didn't come up with enough. Something is better than nothing, and I encourage those officials in those government agencies to do whatever they can to attract business to the area. And then once they do, I encourage our young people to try and shop here, work here, and live here. Okay, running out of town isn't going to make it better for you or the county. And then, last but not least, participate in what's going on in and around Newcastle and Lawrence County. I can't say that enough. One of the people that I had been talking to walked into one of our athletic events and said, geez, that the people that go to these athletic events, are they really old? Now, it wasn't talking about the younger individuals. It was talking about the people that go over and over and over again. We have to work at getting those young people to come to those athletic events, those cultural happenings, whether they be an art exhibit or a play, anything else along the line. If we don't get participation in those things, you're not going to get participation in the bigger things. Now, for Focus NC, I'm Angelo Parada. Here's hoping you have a really great day.
There are people in this country who work hard every day. Not for fame or fortune do they strive, but the fruits of their labor are worth more than their pay, and it's time a few of them were recognized.